Thanks for logging on to the PawCast for the week of Monday, October 21st through Friday, the 25th. Hi, I'm Mr. Andrews.
And I'm Mrs. Williams.
And here's what's happening on our team this week.
In reading this week, we are going to be looking at the Explorers and Colonial Times. We will be working with the Colonial Times and the Explorers as we head into the next unit. Students will be working towards creating a tableau. They will be creating a diary blog and another activity of their choice. So all of the activities for the next 2 weeks will point towards this culminating project. So social studies will be integrated completely into reading. Students will get a reading log, and we will continue our word study. So your child has a word study sheet, and we will continue doing activities with those.
In Sciences Week, we will be starting a new unit of study, heat energy. We'll begin by talking about things such as the water cycle and where does water vapor come from. Then we'll talk about thermal energy and the three most common ways that heat energy travels: conduction, convection, and radiation. Also be looking for your child's weather assessment that was taken on this past Thursday. That will come home in your child's Monday work folder. If you have any questions or comments about that, please send me an email or give me a call at school. This week's Scientist of the Week was Nicholas Copernicus.
Oh, and one more thing I almost forgot. Students will have a quick quiz on Westlandia on Monday. Students will be able to use the book. However, we did read the story in class, so it'll just be a quick quiz. Just want to let you know.
In Math This Week, we have a full slate of things going on. We're going to begin by comparing and ordering decimal numbers. Then we'll shift our attention to multiplying decimal numbers and whole numbers. For a deeper, richer experience, we're going to start that by modeling. We'll use quick pictures in order to be able to do this. And then we will start using an area model to solve multiplication of decimal and whole numbers, and then the standard algorithm. You can also expect a pop quiz almost at any time during the week. So every night, students should go home and try their best to show their parents how they have solved problems that day. Also be aware that on Wednesday of this week, I will be collecting students' NFL graphs. I will check both the bar graph and the line graph side and give you a grade for the first 7 weeks of the season. Hopefully that's going to be 2 100s. They will be averaged for test grades. I will then hand back the graphs to each student by the end of the week so they can start working on the next parts of the graph. I'll collect those at the end of the second quarter. And now for the bonus question. This week we are approaching the final week of the first grading period. We would like for you to do some reflecting. What do you feel like you have grown the most at doing or gotten better at doing during this first grading period of fifth grade? And secondly, we would like to know what are your goals for the second 9 weeks? Mrs. Williams and I look forward to reading your responses. To get credit for your response, you know you must have a signature of your mom or dad. That lets us know that you also had them watch this podcast. Let's all have a great week together, and let's all get the big paw.